This is Poppy. She's an 11-month-old Cavapoo, and she is available. She's been in our training program, so she does all the kindergarten skills. Her family, she had a family, but her family, you know, couldn't get her, as it turned out, so she is back available, and we wanted to give you a little glimpse of her today and let you see just what a wonderful, sweet lap dog that she is. So I'll run through the skills, and then we'll also talk about a temperament test. So there's an implied every time that I stop that she should stop and sit while we're healing. So she does really good with this. This is so if you're walking along the street and you meet a neighbor friend and you're going to stop, eventually if I stay here a little bit longer, she would lay down as she's doing now. They're all kind of taught that, and it's just good manners if you're out or trying to pay like a cash register or something. That is so good. Heel. So I can go ahead and heel from that command, you know, from being down. Go to bed. With this command, it's implied that they get in, lay down, turn around, and stay there until I tell them to get out. And of course, all the commands, we B-R-E-A-K from every command. Break! Good job! Oops, step on a leash. You step on a leash. Yeah. Place. We also do come as part of our kindergarten. You can kind of use come to break interchangeably. They kind of mean both mean the same thing. Come to me and sit down in front of me. Break. Good job.
Good job.
Stay it down when they're on a place on the bed. They can also stay down just when you tell them down. Again, we use this in stores and things like that if we're shopping. Come.
Good girl.
So that time I use the come command, and you see either one works whether you're doing come or break. It means the same thing. I think because we use break more frequently, you know, break might work a little bit better, but they do know come. Go potty.
Good job. Good job.
I hope you enjoyed seeing Poppy today. If you're interested in Poppy, be sure to get an application to get started. We'd be glad to work with you. And again, it's a good opportunity to get a great dog for just a regular puppy price. I'm back here with Miss Poppy, and I thought we would go over her temperament evaluation. So there's 7 or 8 skills that we look for. The assertiveness, she scored low to medium. Confidence was high. Motivation level to learn to work was high. Nerve strength and resiliency was high to medium. Touch tolerance was high. Energy level, medium to high. Sight and sound sensitivity were both low, and that is what you want. That means that they didn't, you know, have any, you know, bad reactions to any sights or sounds in the video. They're dropping things and poppers and making noises and just showing them all kinds of stuff to see like how they react, and she did extremely well for that. Toy drive was high. Human focus was high. She can occupy herself with toys since she really likes toys, and she also carries toys in her mouth and, you know, runs around with them, so that's really cute too. I'm talking about you. I sure am. Human focus is high, as you see, she's quite the cuddler. And tender-hearted is medium to high. Dog friendliness is neutral. And so for the notes that they said that she's a very good worker, she's a happy-go-lucky type of dog, and she's very loving. And really, she's just looking for a family that's looking for a lap dog. She just loves to sit in your lap and cuddle. It is a unique opportunity to get a dog that already knows several of the kindergarten skills, and for the regular price of just a regular puppy. If you're interested in Miss Poppy, just be sure to send us an email, fill out an application, and get started.